Nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it.
Yeah.
Oh, fudge!
Yeah, well, my DeLorean, we know how to fly it.
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we going to stop her?
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my alternate self put all over her DeLorean have given me an idea. Here, take these.
What are these?
Flux signalization modules.
How do they work?
Who's he
I
what?
Generally use them for maintenance purposes. We might be able to use them to sync
them
up alternate DeLorean's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean. At least that's the theory, anyway.
That's a great
nice
plan,
stock,
I think.
Best of all, we won't need
if it works.
Just snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
How did you do it before?
Aha!
Yeah, I saw this item in the trailer.
Saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like the appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Sweet!
Yeah, I saw that bit that the hoverboard existed in the trailer, so I figured this looked like the place where it would show up.
You okay?
It's just like riding a bike.
You ready to make
except at like 80 miles per hour.
Ready, Doc.
And,
one,
on a skateboard.
Two, three, jump!
Whoa.
Nice form, buddy. How's the reception on the wireless?
Great. Where'd you get these?
From Burns Cash on 21st century video game consoles. Now remember, all you've got to do is attach the flux sync modules to those diagnostic lights.
Will do, Doc.
Alright. So... yeah, just try and stay outside there, Marty.
All right.
Nicely done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
I'll try, but it's getting a little bumpy out here. I can't talk to her from here.
Yeah, don't think I want. Good. That's good. Come on. Okay, there we go. Ooh.
Great, that's one flux sink down, two to go.
Great. So I guess I need to find other flux emitters.
I can't reach it from here.
Just have to climb onto the top.
Oh, great.
Is that one of the flux emitters?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
Mr. Fusion, should I disable it?
Leave it alone. It's not a good idea to monkey with nuclear reactors.
Oh, why not? I do that all the time. No, don't think so.
I can't reach it from here.
Just have to climb onto the top.
Okay, assuming the other one's on the other side, I'm guessing, I should wait until last to put that on. This here to get her to not look at me.
Get off!
Already get lower. So she can't see you.
I can't sneak past the rear view mirror.
Okay, can I do something about the rear view mirror?
Get off!
I can't
can't sneak past the rearview mirror.
I don't know if I could do something to stop
it. Mr. Fusion!
Maybe you have to go around the other way? Okay, so let me guess. Anytime I try and go up there, it's not gonna. Uh-oh.
Fusion's belching flames!
Yes, that's unfortunate. I'd stay out of them if I were you.
So, I guess he's saying that I shouldn't go around the back again.
Marty!
I'm okay. Reach it from here.
You just have to climb onto them.
Yes, but how do I do that?
Don't cross those flames. They may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
So how can I? It's not like I got much I can do.
It's locked.
That figures. Alright. It's not letting me onto the
floor. Careful, Marty!
So.
Don't worry, I got it!
Seems to be the only thing that let me do.
Mr. Fusion's belching flames!
Yes, that's unfortunate.
So, what, let me climb on top of the car? Okay, maybe I need to go to the front now. Okay, there's something. Now, can I get up on the roof? Because that's what he's saying I need to do. I assume it's right. Oh wait, am I supposed to... I'll try this one first.
Careful, Marty!
Didn't think so.
Don't worry, I got it!
Okay, I'm guessing I need to close Mr. Fusion so I can get around the other side or something. Yeah, okay.
Good. Nice work, Marty.
Though you'd think by containing the sparks, radioactivity, radiation, and whatnot, that would probably be a bad thing to do.
Mr. Fusion!
It's just, I kind of want you to climb on top of the car, but I guess you're not going to do it from this angle. Is the rearview mirror broken now? Yeah, that seems to be what it is. So it looked like she was looking for where she'd be able to see.
Now let's get that difficult.
Like she's been making it easy up till now?
Yeah, really. Oops, no, not that. There we go.
Well, here goes nothing, Doc. Whoa!
Perfect! Now, aim the focusing towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish, check!
Alright. There we go. Dish 2 aligned.
We're almost home, Marty. Just one
Okay, so we need to get on top of it.
It's locked!
Yeah, but you opened the window.
It's one of the flux emitters.
Yeah, so climb up.
Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Who said that?
Marty! Are you alright?
Not really. I can't reach it while the window's shut.
What?
Pull over!
No!
You're in a lot of danger!
So are you!
Give it up!
Yeah, that's true.
You first!
Excellent, Marty. Now that you're on top of the memorial, attach the flux
sink
to the overhead
flux
emitter.
That's great, Doc.
Yeah. It'd be nice if I didn't have to go flipping over cars to do it, but...
Nicely done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
You say so, Doc. Oh, great, got it. What if I don't know? Not that makes a difference, really. There we go.
That's it! Get out of there, Marty!
Phew.
The flux synchronizers, and that's strange.
What?
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home now. Hold on.
Towing her into the future. Ouch. Why was there a building in the middle of the road later on? I don't know. Well, I suppose it wasn't really there. Oh, is it the barn? That'd be funny. Probably not, though. Well, then again, all of Hill Valley's back now, so...
Parker, then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
What? No! You can't arrest me. Not now. I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll bring it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it! Unhand me, you dolt!
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell? Hey, Parker! You're not gonna believe this.
See? What'd I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc. The timeline's not fixed yet. Look.